Hello students, yesterday we studied about the solubility of gases, okay, and in that we studied about the effect of pressure on the solubility of gas in water. And the effect of pressure was, when we increase the pressure on the surface of water, it causes increase in the solubility of gas in water. It means if gas, it is insoluble or very least soluble in water, then if it'll increase the pressure on the surface of water, that gas, it will be dissolved in water under high pressure. Now today we will see the effect of temperature on the solubility of gases. Like, we know that many gases are dissolved in water. So what will happen if we will increase the temperature of the water? So what will be the effect of that increase in temperature on the solubility of water, or solubility of gases in water, solubility of gases in water? So here we'll see an increase in temperature of water. If we will increase the temperature of water, how we will increase? We'll put container on the flame. So if we'll increase the temperature of water, it causes decrease in the solubility of gas in water. It means that when we will put water on flame and we will supply temperature to it, or heat to it, we'll supply heat to it, its temperature will increase. And when its temperature will increase, the dissolved gases will escape from water. The dissolved gases, they will escape out from water. It means on increasing the temperature of water, the solubility of gases in water, it decreases. Okay, the dissolved gases will be escaped out. See, the point is here, on boiling, water loses its taste. When we boil the water, the taste of water is lost. Why it happens? Water contains soluble gases which contributes to the taste of water. There is some taste of water, okay, and otherwise what we used to say, that water, it is tasteless. But if you drink normal water and boiled water, you will feel the difference between that. And that taste of water, which is actually the taste of water, it is due to the soluble gases in it. And when we boil the water, upon boiling, the dissolved gases escape out from it and the taste of water changes. Okay, on boiling, the temperature of water increases. Yes, we know that when we boil the water, when we'll put the water on flame, the temperature of the water, it will increase, and thereby the solubility of the dissolved gases decreases. All the dissolved gases, whether it is air, all these gases, their solubility, it will decrease on increasing the temperature of water, and the dissolved gases are hence expelled out. So all the dissolved gases, they will escape out on increasing the temperature of water. If the water above water is once again shaken with air, means if we'll put that water for some time, then the water, it gets back its taste due to dissolution of air in water. The air will again be dissolved in water, and that water, it will again get its taste back. Okay, so it means that the taste in water, it is due to the presence of the dissolved air or dissolved gases in it. Now second one is, gases are more soluble in cold water than in water at high temperature. Obviously we have read it here also, and soda contains carbon dioxide dissolved in water under pressure. Soda water, cold drinks we drink, they all contain carbon dioxide which is dissolved in water, and that too under high pressure. If we'll open the cap of cold drink bottle, after some time we'll see that the taste will totally change. The taste of the cold drink will totally change, and it will only remain sweet in taste. Okay, so all the fizziness and all the taste of the cold drink, it was just because of the presence of dissolved carbon dioxide in it. And carbon dioxide, it is not readily soluble in water, it can be mixed with water under high pressure only. When a soda bottle kept at ordinary temperatures is opened, if we'll put it in ordinary temperature and we'll open it, the evolution of carbon dioxide is less compared to similar chilled soda bottle. If the bottle is very chilled, then we'll compare with the bottle which is kept at ordinary temperature, which on opening produces more effervescence. Suppose there are two bottles, one is kept at ordinary temperature and the other one is very chilled. If we will open the cap of both the bottles, more effervescence will be seen in the chilled soda bottle than the bottle which was at ordinary temperature. It means that gases are more soluble in cold water. Thus, at low temperatures, the solubility of gas is more. It means at lower temperatures, the solubility of gas, it is more in liquid as compared to the higher or ordinary temperatures. Even not at ordinary temperatures, see. Okay, it means suppose temperature is 10 degree and temperature is 25 degree. So, it means that at 10 degree, the gases will be more soluble in liquid. Oxygen is more soluble in water than nitrogen. Oxygen, it is more soluble. Hence, dissolved oxygen or dissolved air in water, it contain a higher percentage of oxygen at than ordinary air. The water, it contains more amount of oxygen than it is present in ordinary air. And this dissolved oxygen, it is used by aquatic plants and animals for respiration and other processes. Thank you.